Hello and welcome to my studio. In this video, I'm going to show you how I made this image. This is an example of just what you can do with rim lighting. By using this lighting technique in conjunction with a window mask, you can achieve relatively high contrast and good colour saturation, yet still have good control over the transition from highlight to shadow. Okay, so let me show you what I've got set up so far. On this table, I have our subject, these tulips, and at the front here, I have my camera. On the front of the camera, I have this 24 to 70 millimeter zoom lens, and on the top of the camera, I have this flash sync trigger. This is also capable of controlling the energy in the studio flashes. The camera is tethered into Capture One software. So the first thing I'm going to do, as I usually do, is just take an image with no flash, just to see what sort of effect the house lights are having on the subject. This is actually quite important. If you don't take into account the ambient light which is falling onto your subject, at the very best you'll end up with a colour cast. At the worst, it can affect the whole of the image. So what I'm going to do is, just with the settings that I have on the camera at the moment, which is 1/50th of a second at 2.8 at 100 ISO, I'm just going to grab an image. So we'll just do that. And you can see from that we're actually getting quite a reasonable image. If I use these settings in conjunction with a studio flash, I'll end up with a bit of a yellow colour cast to the whole of the image, and I won't be able to control the shadow areas very well. So what I'm going to do is just change the shutter speed from 1/50th of a second to 1/250th of a second, which is the flash sync speed for that camera. Also, the aperture at 2.8 is probably a little large for this subject, so it'll end up with a narrow depth of field. So again, I'm going to change that to a more reasonable f8. So with these new settings, I'll grab another image and see what happens. There we go, that's much better. So there's no image to speak of there at all at these settings. Okay, so with that experiment out of the way, it's time to put in a light. Now, I mentioned at the beginning that this is rimlit. Therefore, what I'm going to do is put a large softbox just about here somewhere, pointing towards the camera, so that we can light the subject from all around. This is a Profoto D2, and on the front of that I have this 4-foot Octo box. So I'm just going to place this about here somewhere, and the idea of this is that I'm going to try and get it relatively close to the subject, just about as close as I can get. And this will form not only the light source, but also the background. So with that in place, I'll just turn on the sync trigger, and I've just set the studio flash to an arbitrary energy level. So I'm just going to grab an image to find out what sort of exposure we've got. So you can see in the resulting image that the background here is at the maximum. If you look at the numbers at the top of the screen here, you can see that they're all 255. I'm not really that bothered about that, but what I am bothered about is the amount of light which is actually falling on the subject. And at this arbitrary energy level, I don't think there's quite enough. Okay, so I'm just going to increase the energy by about 2 stops. There we go. And we'll try that again. Yeah, that's increased the amount of light on the subject. It's all a little wishy-washy, and there is no dark background as we had in the original image. So in order to make a dark background, what I'm going to do is introduce a flag just here, which is made out of a piece of black cloth. And that will give a dark background to just this subject area. The rest of the softbox here will be left to illuminate the subject. Here we are. So this is the flag, which I have on this C stand. And I'm just placing this so it's just behind the subject. And as you can see, there is quite a large amount of the softbox around the sides that can still wrap around light to illuminate the subject. So with that just roughly in place, I'll grab another image. There we are, you can see that that's starting to come together. I do need to recompose the image a little, I think. There's far too much area around here which I'm not actually going to end up using. So in order to do that, what I'm going to do is just look through the viewfinder and zoom in a little. I'm at the 24mm end on this lens at the moment, so I'll just recompose that image. So I'll just zoom that in. There. That's not too bad. I think the focus is about in the right sort of place. There. So with that recomposed, I'll just grab another image. Now you can see in this image that it's actually starting to come together a little. We've got a dark background, but generally the contrast is pretty low over the whole image. Now that is caused by lots and lots of flare from all of this area of light hitting the front of the lens. And using a normal hood or something similar, you won't be able to get rid of that. So instead of doing that, you use a window mask, which is basically just a piece of card, which I've just cut a hole into the centre of, which is more or less in the same ratio as the sensor in the camera. So I'm just going to place this card in front of the subject, in between the subject and the camera, and basically just put this so that it's only just out of view. Yeah, so I'm just sliding it on this stand, and we'll just place it about there somewhere. So you can see that we have the subject here, we have the black flag at the back, this is the softbox, and this is the window mask. Now the position of this window mask is actually quite critical. So what I'm going to do is just look through the viewfinder of the camera and adjust this until I got it in exactly the right position. First thing I'm going to do is just move it ever so slightly forwards, like that, and then just slide it round until it's in the right place. Okay, so with that set, what I'm going to do now is just grab an image, and that should have a lot less flare in the capture. Let's see what we get. There we are, that's a vast improvement in terms of flare over the previous image. This is what we had before, and this is what we've got now. Okay, so I think overall it's actually slightly dark. So I think what I'm going to do is add a couple of stops and just see what that looks like. So we'll just add two stops of energy, like so, and fire that again. There we are, that's added a bit of punch to it, and it's also saturated the colour quite nicely. But one of the things about this image is that it looks like it's a little overlit from below. You can see the underside of all these heads is lit quite well. So I think there's some fine tuning to be done here. So one of the things that you can do with this sort of arrangement is modify the flag at the back here. So down here I have yet another piece of card. So I'm just going to place this piece of card in the back here, just to flag off a little bit more of the background, just so it stops that illumination from this part of the softbox reaching the underside of the subjects. So with that in place, we'll grab another image. There we are, that's a nice improvement, I think. This is what we had before. You can see the underside of all these tulip heads lit. And this is what we've got now. But looking at the overall composition, I think it might be useful to throw the flower in the background a little bit further out of focus. So what I'm going to do is change the aperture from f8 to f4, which will give me a smaller depth of field. Now obviously that's a two-stop change, so in order to compensate for that I will need to take the energy down in the light by two stops. So I'll do that now. There we are. And we'll shoot that again. Yes, I think that's made quite a nice improvement. It's taken these down a little in terms of focus so that your attention is drawn to this one in the centre. Let's just have a close look at that and just see, just to make sure everything is in focus that I want it to be, which it looks like it is. And yet the background's gone quite a long way out. This is what we had before, and this is what we've got now. Okay, so with that image captured, it just remains to go into Photoshop and do a little bit of retouching. So here we are in Photoshop. So the first thing I'm going to do is just make a copy of this background image. So I'll right click on the mouse and just go down to duplicate layer, and we'll just make a copy of that. So we can work on the copy, and then if I want to do anything else, I've always got the background, which is untouched. Right, so the first thing that I'm going to do is just reset the black point so that this background is actually black. If you look at these numbers up here in the info panel, as I sweep across the image, you'll see that they're actually not zero. It's ever so slightly not black. So what I'm going to do is just add an adjustment layer, and I'm just going to add a levels adjustment layer, and using the eyedropper tool here, I'm just going to reset black to zero. So I'll just find a suitable point somewhere around here and we'll click on that. There we go. So now, again watching the numbers at the top, you can see that the black is now actually black. Okay. So with that little bit done, the next thing to do would be just to get rid of all of the spurious distracting parts of the image around the outside. So I find the easiest way to do that is literally just to add a new layer, then making sure that black and white is selected and black is the foreground colour. I'm basically just going to paint all this out. So just using a paintbrush, make that a reasonable size. And it's very soft. So we'll just go over that and just painting on that layer, I'll just paint out all those distracting elements. There we are. Jolly good. So, I think the only other thing that I might want to do now is just apply a crop to the whole image. So, if I just go up to the crop tool up here, now I'm going to pick a specific ratio, which is 16:9, because that matches the video extremely well. But you could pick something which matches the subject if you've got something of a different shape. So, we'll just move that around a bit. Until we're happy with the result. Something like that. I'll just click on OK. And there we have it. I think this image has turned out very well. The contrast and colour saturation achieved straight out of the camera suits the subject and combined with the limited depth of field makes for a striking result. Very nice image. So that just shows what you can achieve with some rim lighting and a window mask. Now if you like watching these sort of things, do click on the other images as they appear and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching.